मौला अब्बास अलैहिस्सलाम का साया आप सब पर रहे। आमीन।
ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوى وتمكنه فيها طويلا برحمتك أرحم الراحمين
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد
ما شاء الله.
To give my condolences for the days of the martyrdom of Imam Hussain alayhisalam to the Imam of our time, Imam al-Mahdi, may Allah hasten his reappearance, and to all of you. May Allah grant us the tawfiq and success to be the best followers of the Ahlul Bayt, especially Imam Hussain. Today, I would like to talk about a very important lesson, which is about the wilaya of Allah versus the wilaya of Tawud. I know you have some questions about this. First of all, what is wilaya? Second of all, who are the awliya of Allah and who are the awliya of the Tawud? Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah is the guardian of those who believe. He brings them out from darkness into the light. And those who disbelieve, the guardians of the Tawud, they take them out of the light into darkness. Those are the companions of the fire. They live in it forever. So let's answer the first question. What is wilaya? Wilaya, also called guardianship in English, is when you take instructions and vision from another person. For example, your parents are your guardians, right? So you listen to them and follow their rules. And in return, they guide you and teach you how to live your lives in the best of way. Well, Allah is our ultimate wali, or guardian, and we are under his wilaya. Now, in order to have wilaya of Allah, the guardianship of Allah, we have to obey His order and be good servants. Obviously, only saying that we are good servants of Allah is not enough. We need to act upon that claim as well. Now, as we obey Allah, learn more about Him and study the Quran. We learn more about the Tawud as well. They are those who obey Shaitan instead of Allah. Allah says in the Quran, those who believe fight in the way of Allah, and those who disbelieve fight in the way of Tawud and Shaitan. In the same verse, Allah says, fight therefore against the friends of Shaitan. Shaitan's plot is certainly weak. We have to fight against the awliya of Shaitan with our good actions first and with strong faith as well. Just like Amir al-Mu'mineen Imam Ali alayhi salam. Amir al-Mu'mineen is the commander of believers. He was the bravest not only on the battlefield, but in every single area of life. Once, while Imam Ali alayhi salam was praying at the masjid, a poor person came and asked him for some money and some help from the other believers at the masjid. Imam Ali, who was in ruku, held up his hand with his aqiq ring so that the poor man could take it out of his finger. The man could sell the ring and use that money to buy something for himself and his family. The noble prophet came to the masjid and he announced that Allah has revealed a beautiful verse about Imam Ali. Let's look at this beautiful verse in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse 55. Indeed, your guardian is only Allah, the messenger, and those who have believed, those who establish prayer and pay the poor rate while bowing down in ruku. The person described in this ayah is Imam Ali. So we learn that our wali, our guardian, is Allah, the messenger, Imam Ali, and the rest of the Ahlul Bayt. Therefore, it is important for us to follow them and live our lives the way they did. It is time for once more for us to take our hearts to Karbala. Hazrat Abbas is one of the best examples of someone who is loyal and faithful towards Allah, his messenger, and the Ahlul Bayt. He was the son of Imam Ali and brother Imam Hussein. The Imam of his time was Imam Hussein. Abbas came to the Imam's tent and said, I can't take it anymore. I see that Ruqayya, Ali Askar, and all the little kids and women of the house of the Ahlul Bayt are that thirsty. I am Abbas, and I feel responsible. Oh, my master. Oh, my Imam, please let me go to the battlefield to sacrifice my life for you. Imam Hussein asked him to bring some water for the children. Abbas said, oh, my master, sure, I'll go and get some water for the children of the Ahlul Bayt. Abbas al-Islam left to get the water, but the enemies of Imam Hussein were not going to let him get any water, even for the thirsty children. Even though Abbas was extremely thirsty himself, when he reached the river, he remembered the thirst of his Imam and the children, and he did not drink any water. He did not want to quench his thirst before the Imam and the children. Abbas filled the water skin and was on the way to the tents of the Imam. But the enemy said, we cannot let Abbas go back with water. So they surrounded him and attacked him however they could. Some people used their swords, some threw rocks and stones at him. Some used spears and attacked him from the front, the back, the right, and the left. They cut both of Hazrat Abbas's hands. He had to hold the water skin with his teeth. Someone shot at the water skin with an arrow and the water started spilling out of the skin. Remember, Abbas's goal was to take some water back to his mom and for the children of the household. But the friends of the Tawhut were attacking him from all directions and hurting him. Hazrat Abbas fell on the ground and called out for his brother, Imam Hussein. This was the first time he called his Imam his brother. He called out, oh, my brother Hussein, please come to me. As soon as Imam Hussein heard this, Abbas' voice, he ran to the battlefield and came to his brother's side. He put Abbas's head on his chest and started crying. Abbas was also crying. Imam Hussein asked Abbas, oh, my dear brother, why are you crying? Abbas replied, firstly, I am crying because I am laying on the ground and I have no hands to hug you, my brother. And secondly, I am crying because I am laying on the ground and my head is on your chest. But after a short time, you are going to be laying on the ground and you will not have anyone to put your head on the chest. Oh Allah, please protect our scholars and parents.
Ameen.
Oh Allah, please give us the strength to always make good choices.
Ameen.
Oh Allah, please help us to become the close friends and helpers of Imam Mahdi. May Allah hasten his reappearance.
Ameen.
Oh Allah, please protect all the children around the world and give them food and shelter.
Ameen.
Oh Allah, please hasten the reappearance of the Imam so we can finally live as good Muslims in a safe
world. Ameen.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Amin.